So this is 2936 South Sierra Heights, located in Mesa, 85212, in the Arizona Skyline subdivision. So this is a 5-bedroom, 2.5-bath with an office, built in 2003, 2,886 square feet on 2 levels, 2-car garage. So from the exterior, we have this nice mesquite tree, just needs to be cut back a bit. It's all desert landscaping. Rock is in good shape, just a few weeds to be pulled here. Driveway, garage door appear to be in good shape, and the fascia also. So I don't think there's anything to be done on the outside, just a few weeds to be pulled here. Actually, that's probably the neighbor's area. This paved area is ours for an extra car to be parked, so just a weed here to be pulled, and that's about it. Gas is locked and off. It'll be turned on after the July 4th holiday. So very clean on the outside. There are sunscreens, which is a plus. That'll keep those energy costs down. Irrigation system is in place. So we'll get that turned back on. The power is on in the house right now, the electric. So basically just a pruning of this tree in the front, and perhaps pruning of this bush here, and that's about it. Pull a few weeds, and that's about the extent of it. Little sitting area, covered sitting area here in the front of the house. Nice door. So as we enter, we have a 12 by 12 tile in the entranceway. To the right, small formal living room. Missing 2 blinds here in this area, and probably a globe for this fixture here. Didn't see it in the house, but missing a globe here. It is an attractive thing, just missing the globe that hides these light bulbs. This is probably maybe a dining room or continuation of a living room on the other side, missing a ceiling fan over here or a light fixture, depending on what we want to use this room for. So family room area here, so color change on this wall. We'll have to do carpet and paint in the house. Missing either a light fixture or a ceiling fan here in this area. And then in the dinette area, again the 12 by 12 tile, missing blinds on these windows here as well as these on the back, and missing a light fixture. Kitchen is done in with a nice black sink, and we're missing the stove and dishwasher, but they're in the garage, so I think Scott can hook them back up. We'll basically need a fridge here, probably a black fridge, and then a microwave in this unit, and then the door handles. The blind appears to be okay, that's here, so in this area. Then the door that goes here is this door that's over here for the heading off towards the laundry room. So as we enter this area here, we have a laundry room, washer and dryer hookup over here, and good amount of shelving for a pantry, I would assume, because there's no other pantry in here, so I assume that doubles as the pantry area over here. The garage, a 2-car garage, the remote opener is there. There is a ceiling fan in here. Missing the top for this attic access. So probably paint the garage here. It's a blue color. I don't know. It'll be up to Scott to decide what he wants to do. And I believe this is probably a water softener that we're going to want to. We're probably going to want to cap or remove. So probably paint the garage. And as I mentioned, here's the stove. It's a glass top stove, you know, so I think relatively new, probably when the house was built in 2003, so I think it can be reinstalled. And then same thing with this dishwasher here. appears to be in decent shape, so I think that those can go back in. They probably just didn't have time to steal them on their way out. So the hot water tank is here. Gas-fired hot water tank is here in the garage. So on this level, we have French doors. It's a five-bedroom house, so I don't think I'd convert this to another bedroom, though, you know, they could if they decided to. Missing ceiling fan and blind, color change, and carpet and paint here. So this would be an office area and could be a guest room. The half bathroom, the powder room, is here with the exception of the light fixture. We'll need to get a new light fixture and color change and paint this room, but it's nice 12-inch tile which continues from the entranceway. So up the stairs to the second level, nice light fixture that's here. So basically just carpet and paint in this area. To the left we have a rather large child's bedroom, color change, blinds, and we'll need a ceiling fan. So I saw a couple of sets of blinds, maybe one set of blinds here, so maybe Scott can use those. Nice walk-in closet for a child's bedroom or teenager's bedroom. This is actually a very large room. So color change, carpet, ceiling fan, and two blinds here in this room. And next is the master. And in the master is a nice bay window. Ceiling fan is in place. The blinds are okay in this room. So leads off to the roof that's over the patio. The neighbors to our side have a nice pool. So renters will have to make friends with them. And so here's our walk-in closet, which is a very large walk-in closet. Good size. So carpet and paint, and here's some extra tile, 6-inch tile it appears. I don't know where that goes. I saw some extra tile probably in here. Probably is the extra tile for in here. Let's have a look. No, this is not tile in here. So the master bathroom, double sink. Just missing one light bulb here to complete the look, and then a separate shower. And the shower head is there, so basically just a good cleaning here and a paint change. Just the curtains, the blinds rather, are there. So that's the master. So basically in here, just the color change on these walls, paint, carpet, and in here, basically a color change and paint, and that's about it that needs to be done. The fixtures are decent. There's no staining underneath here. The drawers are all in place, so we're in good shape in the master. So down the hall to our left we have the kids' bathroom, so shower tub combination. Everything appears to be in good shape. Basically just remove these nails. Maybe we'll need a towel, something to hang towels on, but other than that, just a color change and paint in here. Little linen closet, so just paint and carpet when we come up and do that. Bedroom number 3, a child's bedroom, color change. Probably need a blind. Ceiling fan is okay, and probably be able to remove these decals here that are on the hopefully be able to remove those decals that are on these closet doors. But other than that, just color change, paint, a blind, new carpet. Bedroom number 4, another child's bedroom, again another color change on the paint, ceiling fan, and blind. And again, a nice walk-in style closet as opposed to those sliding doors. So, you know, really good size bedroom for a kid's bedroom here. And bedroom 5, a little bit smaller child's bedroom, probably a standard 10 by 10 that we normally see. And color change in here, missing a ceiling fan. There is some sort of a blind here, I don't know. And again, another nice walk-in closet here. So, you know, these are for a child's, and then this dresser obviously will have to be put out to the curb and donated, or one of our guys will probably take that. So that's the top floor. So basically ceiling fan and blind in this room here, and a color change. Color change and a ceiling fan here. So that's two ceiling fans. This room, just a color change and paint. This bathroom, basically a color change, paint, and maybe a towel holder up here. You know what, they took the toilet paper holder, so toilet paper holder. Down the hallway, just paint and carpet in the master. Basically color change and paint and change the carpet. And nothing really in here. Toilet paper holder is there. The towel bar is there. So just basically a color change in here. And in the fourth or the fifth and last bedroom upstairs, ceiling fan, a couple of blinds, though there was one in that closet, carpet and paint in here. And that's pretty much it. Nice. Again, another nice large walk-in closet, this time some built-ins with some for some shoes, so that we can definitely keep. So let's head downstairs and have a look at the backyard, which is in pretty decent shape and won't require all that much. Well, a couple of extra fire extinguishers that haven't been used. The safety pins are in there, so there's already one installed in the garage, so maybe Scott can take these and reuse them into another home of ours, because they both appear to be brand new or operable. So in the backyard, we've got a covered patio, which is in good shape, doesn't show any signs of any leakage from up above. And this concrete has been treated with epoxy. Though the garage hasn't been, they treated this area here with epoxy, which is nice. So basically we have two beautiful queen palms that are very mature and very nice, and once the water comes back on, and we have this nice grassy area that I'm sure will come back once we turn the irrigation on. So I don't think we'll need to add any grass here. We'll just need to water this and bring this back. Some garbage junk that'll need to be removed, and there's some in the garage as well, so probably one container of where our guys will have to remove that. So basically the rest of the backyard is rock. Two AC units are in place, and in this area here we could probably leave it as rock, or there's two irrigation lines, so if we wanted to do some plantings here we could, but if not we can just cap these irrigation lines and just leave it and just get some extra rock to cover whatever was in this section here, whether it was a hot tub or a kid's place area or something that was there before, just to cover that up with more rock and just pull these weeds. That's basically what the backyard needs. So it's an attractive backyard, you know, queen, good sized backyard. There's room in this area later for someone to put a pool in here. So it's a, you know, it's a 7,600 square foot lot. So definitely a really nice area in here to have a pool, but it's got a nice covered patio, these two queen palms, and you know, this nice grass area for kids to play. So all in all, a pretty nice house. 2936 South Sierra Heights in Mesa, and the zip code is 85212.